studied in their widest connotation, for they contain the basic mystery of sex on the evolutionary path and on the evolutionary. In them we have the two extremes. It will have been noted that in the idea of the physical vehicle of the logos and the body of manifestation of grasp, many problems become elucidated, and two points especially will gradually be apprehended by the student if he meditates and studies. First, that in due course of time, as the logos,
eventually withdrawing.
forming life, having a chain is simply a center in the body of the planetary logos, yet having its own central factor. This can be seen in the moon in a most interesting way. The desire of this occupant was no longer for physical manifestation, he therefore withdrew his life. All that is left is the revitalized shell, the two other aspects of non and only the third aspect, the inherent life of matter itself, remains gradually to dissipate also as the centuries elapse. In connection with man, a similar con. Vision is seen in the gradual disintegration of the physical body after death. The two other aspects are removed, and the form decays. As these fundamental facts are grasped, and man begins to appreciate his position as creator, the entire aspect of the sex question will also change, and emphasis will be laid upon the laws of mental creation, on the formulation of thought forms in a scientific manner, and the dense physical aspect of creation will be in abeyance. When this is so, then will man be coming into his divine right, and the human kingdom be fulfilling its legitimate function. The sex aspect as at present expressing itself in the whole process of reproduction is one which man shares with the animal kingdom, and is based upon his animal instinct, and his dense good in the nature, which is not a principle. When he is totally emancipated from the animal kingdom, and the third and fourth kingdoms stand distinct from each other, then the sex nature, and the organs of reproduction will be viewed by the average man in a very different manner than at present. Impulses and not desired impulses. The process will be then once the initial impulse on the mental plane has been given as normal, as safe, and as unconscious as the act of breathing is now. When this is so and the time is a long way ahead, physical reproduction will still continue, but the physical form will be spoken of in terms of concretion and of energy, and the emphasis will be laid upon that which is to be embodied. This stage will be entered upon when the functions of the etheric body are scientifically grasped and understood, and the laws of creative thought are a matter of public knowledge and discussion. It will coincide with the period wherein the animal kingdom will again be under manifold oppression, and individualization will again be permitted. 560 ATREATISCONCOSMICFIRE. It will be generally recognized at that time that spirit matter are two aspects of the one unity, and the present terminology of spirit and material substance will have given place to the broader concept of negative and positive energy as the two aspects of the one energy. All phenomena will then be expressed in coarse terms. And the sex question and the union of the male and female, the negative and the positive, on the physical plane will be redeemed and purified. An embodied idea, therefore, is literally a positive impulse, emanating from mental levels, and creating itself in a veil of negative substance. Two factors in turn will be regarded as emanations from a still greater force center, which is expressing purpose through them both. Avant form, as constructed by man, is the union of a positive emanation and a negative. These two are the emanations of a unity, a coherent thinker. See, to carry out specific purpose. true fundamentally of all forms. We're the relative zeros in the unimportant forms such as those constructed by man at this time are concerned. This can easily be discovered, and to the trained clairvoyant each form reveals the important. By each color, by each vibration, by each direction, by each keynote, nature of the inner light, the quality of its vibration and the nature of its goal. In the summation of all these points where you purposely reveal itself. The factor of karma, every thought form comes under the law of karma through the effect of karma. At this stage in the history, just in that vast transitional stage between the physical life and existence, etheric body, it is not easy for us to differentiate between those thought forms which are effects and those which are causes. It should be remembered here that only cosmic and solar lords formulate thoughts. The lunar lords and all lesser intelligences do not do so. Therefore, the two above mentioned gifts come under karmic law. They only are self-conscious, and therefore responsible. Where self-consciousness is not, there is no responsibility. Hence animals are not held to be responsible, and though they are in THRUGHTANDFIRELEMENTALS 563 suffer on the physical plane and in their physical vehicles. On the subtler plane they are free from karma, for they have neither memory nor anticipation. They lack the correlating faculty, and as the spark of mind is missing, they are held free from the law of retribution, except where the physical body is concerned. The reason for that, suffering in the animal kingdom is hidden in the mystery of the sin of the mindless. Adian in that terrible period spoken of in the secret doctrine, which resulted in abortions and distortions of all kinds. Had this period not occurred, this particular type of miscarriage of purpose had not taken place, we should not have had the miracle. The karmic relationship is now between the third and the fourth kingdom. Affected a life and persistence of a thought form, if maleficent and destructive, works out its evil karma, if beneficent it works its good karma, in the group in which the emanator has a place. This is what is meant by there being no karma attached to the working out of a good in all created beings. The factor of the lesser builders. Here a most interesting factor comes in upon which we shall enlarge later, when considering the elementals. Here a specific purpose of a thought form is connected very closely with the type of Vita essence of which it is constructed, and in connection with man on the mental plane with the type of elemental which is in the sense forces the occupier, are vitalizing agents. Roughly speaking, a solar logo works only through the greater builders, the monosomy written there. 80% of the mindless, CF, P, 2, 195, 201. This sin has to do with the period of the separation of the sexes in the early third grade, Lemurian. Same historical fact is hinted at also in the Bible in Genesis 2:4. They, the sexes, had already separated before the ray of divine reason had enlightened the dark region of their hitherto slumbering minds, and had sinned. That is to say, they had created a unconsciousness by producing an effect which was unnatural. See also S. 2, location of the above four points in connection with purpose. In a thought form, much can be worked out by the student himself. In extending these ideas to the solar layer, many questions of interest arise which are profitable on the end. So far as they expand the concept and widen the horizon of the thinker. Thought forms when they subtle bodies coordinate around their microcosmic center. The third law is the law of economy, and is the law which adjusts all that concerns the material and spiritual evolution of the cosmos to the best possible advantage and with the least expenditure of force. It makes perfect each atom of time, and each eternal period, and carries all onward, and upward, and through, with the least possible effort, with the proper adjustment of equilibrium, and with the necessary rate of rhythm. Unevenness of rhythm is really an illusion of time, and does not exist in the cosmic center. We need to ponder on this, for it holds the secret of peace, and we need to grasp the significance of that word truth, for it describes the next racial expansion of consciousness, and